Hey guys, and welcome back to another Life is Strange video. My name is Matt's Game Life, or you can just call me Matt. Last I left you guys off, we had only just started Steph's story. This episode before that, we had finished the game, for anyone that's new, that didn't know. And that's really about it to catch you up, guys. We started Steph's story, did a few things in her booth, and walked out into the store. But yeah, let's just get back into playing it and see how far we can get in half an hour, because I'm only wanting to record for half an hour, guys. Faster loading into Steph's story than it is to the other one. Huh.
Hello? You're on KRCT Radio and you're talking to Steph.
Yo, this the record store?
Depends what you mean by this.
What?
See, this is a radio booth within a record store. And this voice you're speaking to, me, is a DJ who also works at the record store. But this phone call, as I mentioned, is decidedly for the radio. Follow?
No. Could I just give you my order, and you can just, like, give it to whoever?
Yeah. Why not?
Sweet. Alright, I got Goodbye Means Forever by Kim Snyder, Going Our Separate Ways by The Seagulls, Don't Let the Door Hit You by Robbie Rooster.
Oh boy.
What?
No, nothing. Just, who are these for?
My girlfriend. I saw them in her wish list online and decided to surprise her. Buy local, you know?
Yeah, cool. Yeesh. I don't think this kid realizes that his girlfriend is loading up on breakup music. Okay. Look. I wonder if your girlfriend might be sending out some signals you're not picking up on?
Yeah, you lost me there.
Alright, dude, listen. I'm pretty sure your girlfriend's breaking up with you.
How the hell would you know that?
Gee, I don't know. Guess I'm psychic.
Whatever, lady. Screw this.
Thanks for calling KRCT.
Well, that didn't go down well, guys. Anyway.
This is Haven's number one indie rock playlist. Pretty sparse. Hear from one of our sponsors. PutToWorkColorado.com has been putting Coloradans to work since 2002 using their super slick job portal. Seriously, I'm not even gonna tell you how it works. It's that easy to use. But Steph, you say, I'm a unique artisan with a highly specialized skill set. No way they'll have a job for me. To which I say, not with that attitude. And just for my listeners, get a free trial membership with promo code KRCT.
Wow.
I'm gonna be shaking up the playlist a bit here at KRCT. So get your ears ready for some fresh tunes. And keep it here. I now officially listen to sweet tunes for a living. Take that, Auto DJ.
Okay, so now I know what I need to do. And apparently we're on Tinder on her phone.
Okay. No total disaster so far. Just gotta make sure I read them all. And now, a message from one of KRCT's sponsors, the Black Lantern. Here in Haven, the Black Lantern is known for... the historical decor. Where else can you feast under a used pickaxe and a literal bullet hole? That's right, nowhere. And then there's the food. Try the lanterns... absurdly spicy jalapeno poppers. Only the strongest of stomach dare attempt to conquer Jed's signature app. Stop by the Black Lantern today and tell him Steph sent you.
Okay, so that's all the ads read. Guess I gotta go out there. How do I leave this?
This place definitely needs an update. If we don't have new releases, what do we have? Throwback time. Then the moonshine will. Treat yourself this Valentine's Day. Call Fred's snow removal. What the hell? I feel like I'd get along with this woman. No contact for 2 years. Then this mysterious package? Well played, Mikey.
Who's Mikey? I open it.
My old GM stuff. Holy shit.
If you need me, honey, I'll be here for you. Even though right now you think
used to be Game Masters.
Mikey really went for the nostalgia. Guess I should look through everything.
Damn. In that high Dungeons and Dragons much? Here's a campaign. No, thank you.
I gifted this to Mikey before I left for Seattle. Wonder if I'd even understand half of it now.
Waiting right here on the other side of town. Where life is hard, but our love came easily.
Fair enough.
Mikey still got it. Elamon, though, has seen better days.
That's a pretty sweet ass drawing.
My old notebook. Dad must have dug it up in my room and given it to Mikey. Oh my god, this takes me back.
Damn, that's a bit brutal. Well, that's... Wow, Steph's really gone into a lot of depth with this.
Need a new Elamon campaign. My old notebook had some ideas in it that might work.
Uh-oh. How do you listen to your portable radio?
One of these might work. That sounds promising. Cool.
Nice. I like it. New poster.
Think about what that animal's done.
That's
in there.
Right.
Thank you. this is Haven's number one indie rock playlist? Yeesh. Looks like I got here just in time. I may have no clue what I'm doing, but the good news is, maybe no one is listening anyway.
Okay.
Haven's number one indie rock playlist? Pretty sparse.
Alright guys, let's go and choose a campaign, because this guy is sadly confused on what he's meant to be doing.
Who's mass producing these mountain paintings for every store in Haven?
Can I use this computer? Nope. Alright, let's choose a campaign. The perfect city. Beneath the fourth and foam. Time of rubies and fire. Rubies and fire sound cool.
Fun to reconnect with Mikey. It's been ages. Jesse James was alive. But am I ready to GM a whole campaign again?
Hell yeah, we are.
Yeah, I am. Eventually, I'll need to get back in the booth.
Uh-oh. Run stuff. Snap, run. Miss a phone call. I think I heard the phone ring.
Howard, who shot Mr. Howard and laid poor Jesse in his grave. It was Robert Ford, that dirty little.
Oh, sorry.
I wonder how he feels. For he ate of Jesse's bread and slept.
KRCT, Steph here.
Hey, are you the psychic?
Really?
Yeah, that's her.
You predicted I was going to dump Danny before I did it, right? So you're psychic.
But that dirty little coward who shot Mr. Howard has laid poor Jesse in his grave. This song was made by Billy Gash.
I'm gonna go that one.
You know what? For the sake of filling some airtime, sure. I'm a psychic. I foretell shit.
That's so cool. Okay, so my best friend for basically my whole life, Tara, and I both got into CU, but then I got into UC, which is my dream school. I know I'm always supposed to follow my dreams, but I'm so scared of what will happen if I go to school without Tara. She's my rock.
That's... Are you sure you want to talk about this with me?
Didn't we just go over this? Are you going to help me or not?
Okay. Just give me a second. Damn. How do I tell this girl's future? Alright. What am I going to tell this girl? 18, huh? That's a strong roll. So, what's my prediction? Everywhere we go. One thing I want to know. What city are we in? I don't know where we're playing. I don't know where we're okay. I think I've got something for you. Ready?
Yes.
Okay. It's tough at first. No one likes long-distance relationships. But then you and Tara discover something that keeps you connected. Reality television carnival workers.
What?
For months, you and Tara audition for every reality TV show you can find. Finally, you get selected. It's a new show called Carny Town, where you compete to see who can build the best carnival attraction. Sure, it tests your relationship. You're there to win, after all, not to make friends. But you come out of it stronger and with more giant stuffed animals than ever.
Tara's gonna flip.
All right. That's all I got. Hope it helped.
I'm not sure, but it was really fun. Thanks, Steph.
I guess that went good, I guess, guys. I'm guessing everything just... Oh, man. This is really... Yeah. Let's see what else we got to do. Cool game. That's a cool game.
Oh my god, am I caller number 12?
Dude, this job you got me?
It's great.
Turns out it's like four jobs simultaneously, and I'm qualified for maybe 3/4 of one? Why did I let you convince me to bullshit my way through that interview?
You know you're on the air, right? And a lonesome frown when they brought me in.
I was fading fast. They put me up on a stool. Avoid situations like these with puttoworkcolorado.com. Hey, Dr. Bartender, elevate your job prospects today. Yeah. Fire up the
jukebox. Start a whiskey out. For a first day, huh?
Yeah. Oh, that was funny. Hey, you know you're on the air? I've got to give it to this game. This game's got a lot of different types of music in this. Pride Month.
Kind Haven listeners, today is the last day of June, and that means we've got one more day to celebrate Pride. One of my favorite promotions this month. Contribute to our Haven Pride mural and get 20% off the Silver Dragon Dispensary. I'm told this discount is participation-based and will not depend on artistic ability. But just in case, here's how you draw a rainbow. Start drawing a circle, then stop. More great music from queer artists coming down the pike. Hold up. I'm getting a vision of the future. It's me, answering your calls in just a few minutes.
Okay.
It's too damn hot to be. What's it called? Talking.
I
All right. The heat's no excuse. Better take this call.
Hey, you're live. What can I do you for?
Hey, well, I think I might have screwed up pretty big with my son.
Oh, okay. What happened?
You're gonna think I'm a real jerk. But my boy Grady sat me down yesterday and he, I guess the term you'd use is, he came out to me. And I could have handled it a lot better than I did.
Well, I don't know if a fake radio psychic is who you need to be talking to right now.
No, you misunderstand. I don't want a reading. Anyway, he loves your show, listens to it religiously, and I thought maybe I could put in a song request on his behalf. Just so he knows I hear him, and I love him.
Hey, everybody screws up sometimes, man. I'm proud of you for trying to make it better.
That's very kind of you.
Just maybe try to be on board from now on. Having a queer kid is an absolute blessing. I wish more dads acted like it.
Yeah, for sure.
What's the track?
It's Feelings by Haley Kyoko. Grady played it for me right before he tried to talk to me. Said it was meaningful to him.
All right. Let me see if I can dig it up.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Pretty sure we've got that record somewhere in the back room.
That's interesting. It's Pride Month now. Apparently, we're just on our first day at the job at the start of this story, and now it's apparently zoomed us up a couple of months, and it's Pride Month. According to the game, man. Some dad just put in an order. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna leave it there for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope this wasn't boring. It's starting to get interesting. The story was already interesting at the start, but I don't know, this looks to be like a great story. So anyone that's been watching, I hope you enjoy, and I will catch you guys on the flip. Bye.